What's up, guys? It's Thales Moustache, and today I'm gonna show you guys the Hollow Thief Twink build. It's finally ready! So basically, this build was made to let you play and do some PvP using the Hollow Thief cosplay. You can see here, it looks just perfect. And it's so funny to play with this build because the attack animation is so fast, it can make people bleed. The critical damage is insane. It will actually surprise a lot of players because they will not expect that much damage on the criticals. So it's basically pretty good. But you have to do the critical hits, the critical damage in order to make it work properly. So you're gonna be fishing for backstabs and repulse. Yeah, that's not too good, you know, people gonna hate it, but this build is basically made for critical attacks. So one thing worth noting is that this build will be ready pretty quickly. None of the equipment will need you to proceed a lot further into the game story. Everything is available pretty early in the game. You can check the step-by-step guide that we write on the comment section in order to follow all the strategies that I use to create this build the fastest way without screwing your playthrough. So that's pretty much it, guys. Now let's move to the basics. So in order to create this build, you're gonna choose the warrior as your starting class and the master key as your gift. I know there's a thief class, but it actually comes at a higher level and it will not be as efficient as the warrior for your starting class. This will be better for you, so just pick it up and you don't need to level up anything. It already comes with everything that you're gonna need. Now let's move to the equipment. This build, you're gonna use the bandit's knife. Here you can see the name is fire knife because we use the fire upgrade path through Vamos to increase a little bit the attack power of this weapon. You can see it's not that big, the attack power. We only have 72 physical attack plus 72 fire attack, which sums up to 145. But hold on, there's a special thing here. What you don't know is that bandit knife has the highest critical modifier among all the weapons with without counting the DLC area. Actually, there's only one weapon that surpassed this critical modifier, which is the Dark Silver Tracer. But it's available very late in the game, and you need more dexterity in order to use that. But this weapon is an extremely true monster when talking about critical hits. When talking about backstabs and repulse, that's a beast, and people will not expect that much damage, because when you hit them with your normal attacks, you're gonna be hitting like for 80, 70, or 50s, and then you backstab them, and then there goes like 500 HP or 600 something. People will be extremely surprised, because they will not expect that much damage. One pretty good thing about this weapon is that it has 300 bleed auxiliary effect, which is extremely good because it has one of the fastest attacking animations among all weapons in the game. So it can make people bleed very easy with this weapon. So that's basically it. The weapon is pretty light. You can get this as a drop from the Hollow Thieves in Lower Undeadburg. I'm gonna talk a lot about this later. So a secondary weapon you could choose is the Dark Hand, which has a higher base attack with 200 physical attack. But the critical damage will actually do less damage than the fire knife. So bear in mind that it will also spoil your cosplay, so I don't suggest you guys use this one. But it's all up to you. If you want to, you can use that as an option. For the shield, we're using the target shield plus 5, which is the shield that the Hollow Thieves themselves use. You can get this on a corpse by the place where you fight the Hollow Thieves. And you can get the black leather set also along with the shield. We upgraded the shield to plus 5 because it will not mess up with our summoning range, because the weapon is also classified as plus 5 as well. And it has low stability, low damage reduction values. But what's important here is the parry frames. We have 8 parry frames opposed to 6 parry frames of the normal shield, so it's more likely that you're gonna actually get the parry in time. With this shield than with other shields such as the grass shield and things like that. So it's pretty good for parrying. Bear that in mind, you're gonna be fishing for critical hits, so that's pretty good for you. Now for the set we're using, of course, the Hollow Thief set. You can see here we upgraded it a little bit. The legs and the chest piece are plus 10 because we got a Titanite slap from the Asylum Demon, and one Titanite slap when we were farming for Titanite chunks from the Dark Wraiths. So you could upgrade 2 pieces to plus 10. The defense values are not that bad. And you can get the set as a drop from the Hollow Thieves themselves, the ones that we are cosplaying, basically. I suggest you use your Covetous Gold Serpent Ring to increase your drop rate chances, but it's all up to you, you don't actually need it. With the ring equipped, it took me 2 trips to get the full set, plus the Bandit's Knife. As I said, you can get this as a drop from the same thieves that you get from the set. So basically, it will not be that hard to farm for those pieces. Now let me show you guys the defense fields. You can see they are not that bad at all. They're actually pretty average with very low weight requirements, which is pretty good. You can see here the chest piece actually has some very good defense values compared to the other pieces, fully upgraded and stuff. And for the legs, those are the defense values. They are not actually bad at all also. Now, one thing, if you want to increase a little bit your defense values, you can use the black leather gloves to increase a little further. You can see now the defense values are a little bit over 250, which is not bad at all considering you're using extremely light equipment. But it will change a little bit your appearance. You can see here the sleeves are kind of rolled now. So it's all up to you. If you want to do a perfect cosplay, you're going to need to use just 3 pieces of equipment, because the Hollow Thieves themselves don't wear gloves. But it's all up to you. The black leather glove will not add much to your appearance and cosplay, but it will increase your defense fails, and it will still let you cartwheel with your with the Darkwood ring. Now, talking about rings, you're gonna need the Hornet ring, because it will increase your critical damage. It will increase your critical damage by 30%, which in combination with the 147 critical modifier of the Bandit's Knife, gonna let you do a shitload of damage to players through critical hits. So basically, you're gonna go to the Darkroot Garden, you're gonna make your way to Sif, and you don't actually need to fight Sif to get this ring. You can just circle around the arena and go to the backside of the tombstone there and just pick up the ring and teleport out of the arena or walk your way back without going in front of the tomb. If you just go in front of the tombstone close to the sword, you will actually trigger the beginning of the fight. But if you don't do that, you don't have to worry about this. So make sure to check the step-by-step guide for a full strategy guide. And for the other ring, we're using the Darkwood Grain Ring, which is also pretty good. It will replace your rolling animation for a cartwheel, which gonna give you more invincibility frames. You're gonna travel a larger distance, and you're gonna roll faster. So it's really, really good. It only works if you have less than 25% of your equipment load. Use it. You can see here, that's pretty much the case. Even if you choose to use the black leather gloves, you can see we can still cartwheel with this equipped, so it's pretty much up to you. And that's basically it, guys. The build is ready. You can see it will not be that hard to get all the items. Every single piece we're using is available pretty early in the game. And make sure to check the step-by-step guide for a full strategy guide, so you don't screw up your playthrough and you make it the fastest way possible. For the multiplayer items, we're using the Eyes of Death through the Gravelord Servant Covenant to let players invade us. Actually, that can be a little bit tricky because we don't have very high defense values, and the twink builds over there are actually getting stronger and stronger, basically because they are making my builds, you know, the Golden Viking, the Dark Beat Spammer, and the Miracle. Yeah, gonna be hard if you let players invade you 3 at a time, but you can invade other players through Gravelord signs as well to increase your chances, and it's all up to you. Do it the way you want. This build is not extremely overpowered, just the critical attacks are, so if you want to try to get the red orb, it's all up to you. It will not be unfair to the other players. The other item, you can use the Dryad Finger to lure Red Phantoms to your world, which is a better choice in my opinion, because a 1v1 situation versus any build is better than a 3v1 situation with strong builds as well. So bear in mind, you can use the Dryad Finger for your advantage to have 1v1 fights, which is easier. You can also summon the Path of the Dragon Covenants for 1v1 fights. It's all up to you. This build is extremely funny to play with. And now I'm gonna show you guys a small clip of me doing some PvP matches so I can actually witness the true power of this build right here. So, thank you for watching, guys, and now, check this out! If only I could turn back.